I knew you as a guy who was sleeping too much.
You know,
a guy who didn't socialize with anyone.
No.
But when I came to know you, man, hey, we did some work. We've done some work.
You know, why you say I was sleeping? Welcome, guys, to my YouTube channel. It's a nice day, a nice time. Hope you guys are feeling good, feeling excited. Yeah, once again, welcoming you with my favorite guy here. So guys, we are doing one of the memorable videos today. I'm not feeling good, but we are doing it's a memorable video, man. We are not going to do a video on rooftop like this attack again another day. So before we continue,
yeah, man,
introduce yourself.
Never on the beat, make everybody freaky.
And me is Oli here. Don't forget to share. Hit that notification button. Every time I bring another video, you'll be there to watch. So guys, it's a long time since we are together.
Yeah, man.
So today we are making an emotional video. As you are seeing, this emotional video.
Yeah,
I'm so much emotional. And I'm so much, one thing, I'm so much happy. Another thing, I'm so much sad. First, how did we meet?
Such
people,
a strange
people way. Like to know how we met.
We met in what can I call it? On the way.
circumstances.
Just
tell me, how did you come to know about me?
I knew you as a guy who was sleeping too much.
You know,
a guy who didn't socialize with anyone.
No.
But when I came to know you, man, hey, we did some work, we've done some work.
You know, why you say I was sleeping? I was working in a funny shift. So, I used to come at around 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
So, I sleep at around 3. Then I wake up at around 10. So, that time when you are coming, me, I'm sleeping. So, that day we met, it was a very funny day. You know how?
Yeah, man.
Because me, that day I'd woken up now. I'm going now to the shower so that I can prepare to go to my shift. Then you hijacked me on the way, you remember?
Exactly.
But you are not expecting that I'm a content creator.
Of course.
Just a normal guy.
Just a normal guy.
But you came found out that this guy has
this
a lot
guy
of
does
content.
Some content, man. Mm-hmm. He has some great shit. Just check out on YouTube.
In fact, you know, so many people maybe knew me from this channel, but I have another channel. I've done more than 100 videos on that channel.
For real?
Yeah. Then I saw it's not growing, then I left that channel, then I focused on this one. My brother told me, stop, that channel is not growing, focus on this one that is growing. That's when I focused. That is how we met. So first thing you told me, you are an
amazing producer
and also a singer,
an artist. Yeah, man.
So what you wanted to? Me subscribe to your channel.
Exactly.
That's how we met.
Man, good day.
So when you told me you're a music producer, I had been looking for a producer for a very long time, but I never found. So I'd given up on that part of content creation. So I'd focus on other things. That's why I bought a camera, I bought a laptop to continue with content creation. But before, I had that passion for music. But you know, the passion was down.
It was dying. Mm.
So now tell me, when I started working with you on the music part,
yeah,
how was I? Be honest, don't lie.
Honest.
Mm. This is honesty, not lying. Just be honest.
The guy was saying, what can I call it? Very bad. Yeah, man. Very, I don't want to put
talk.
It's very so shit music. Very shit, man. But once he started working, I put in some knowledge into him and this guy, man. We've had some growth since we started recording.
You know why I tell you it is like that?
Yeah.
When we started, it was something I had not done for a very long time. So I lost interest in it. So it was now reviving interest in it. You know, I had some songs I'd written before. And you know, only one song that we recorded from the before? The first one?
A Lesson.
No. Anita.
Anita.
Lesson is when I have polished everything. When you are down now in city center.
Yeah.
Now I've polished. So now I've come up with some good writing skills. But Anita was the one that you sent me a beat.
Uh-huh.
So I was just listening to the beat, and one day we met and we recorded the song.
Exactly.
You remember that time?
Exactly.
And the problem was that me, when you are coming, I'm sleeping. So it was hard for us to
exactly.
record that song.
Yeah, man. Yeah, the recording process here in Qatar is not easy.
Because maybe you know
it's not a job. Yeah, man.
And finally you have managed to record many songs now, because when you are free now.
Exactly.
But we are facing hurdles. For example, in your room.
Ah.
That's the reality. Someone that was chasing me from going to record.
Ah, no, man.
Yeah, we are telling the truth. What are you hiding?
You face
hurdles.
Yeah, man. Hurdles are there, yeah. Mm. But you know, if you want to do something, you do it, regardless of everything that's happening.
Now another question I ask you.
Yeah.
I used to tell you, use auto-tune on my music. Why did you refuse it? Tell people now.
Ah, let me tell people. It's not good to use auto-tune because it can change the way you are singing. So it's my way type of recording is I need people to sing until they can get where they are singing very nice. You get me? Without using auto-tune. If auto-tune is a must, we'll use it. But we have to go through that process.
So
it's a process.
You say so in chocha msani.
Yeah. Una chocha msani mpaka na hii. But analeta ile singing vibe.
But auto-tune makes an artist lazy.
Yeah, it will make you lazy. For sure it will make you lazy.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
That's why you refused and you forced me. That's
exactly.
Why, before we continue, you have made me sing high notes.
That you've never thought about
even
in your
about.
Life.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's what removing out of you does.
Me
makes
from,
an artist.
I started as a rapper.
Yeah.
Now you've even made me nowadays. I used to also sing.
Hello. That's the thing, bro.
So guys, this is a song we did. That one you're going to do a video. You'll see that song. It's called, which song do you want me to do a video?
Tabasam. There's a song this day called Tabasam. That song is very nice. That's after working for a whole year. That song came out nice. Check it out, man. The guy is going to do a video, Oliver here. He's going to do a video, check it out. I highly recommend it.
A video?
Yeah.
The others will come later. The others are nice songs, but that one is the one we want to to release the first song.
And,
first, you know, the song that you release the first one determines who the artist is. So you don't just release or make a video for a song that you are. It's not vibable with people. Another song you did also means another nice song. It's called Happiness. Also a very nice song.
Yeah, Happiness is also nice.
But let's start with Tabasam. You recommend that
one? Start with Tabasam first, and then we'll think what we need.
There are so many.
Yeah,
you can count how many?
I can't even put it into number.
More than 20 we have done.
More than 20, yes. There are many songs.
Of course, the latest one are so much hot.
Yeah, man.
So guys, you listen to the latest one. After growth, you know, as an artist, you grow. Don't just release one song, then you say, they release one song.
Yeah.
When it hits, they learn. Everybody can listen to two songs in one day.
That's your limelight. That's your time to shine, man.
So,
shine with them.
When you release a song and it is like this, ensure before you release that song, you have a lot of a catalog. So you have time to, even when you are touring, doing shows, you have songs you are releasing.
Exactly.
But if you just release one, it hits, you will be lazy.
You'll be very
lazy. Because you'll not be focused on releasing good music. We'll be focused on releasing hits. You see?
Yeah, man.
So,
but what I can say onto that, if you love the music, man, you'll never stop recording.
You record every
single time. For me, I record every single time. Once I get something bad happening in my life, I record about it.
And guys, for me, I had that passion in music. I had given up on it because, you know, life pushes you to do other things. But you see, it is destiny, me and you meeting up at that funny instrument. I want to be a subscriber, bring your phone, I subscribe to my channel. Then
exactly.
We meet and do projects. Even I don't believe that I can do a song that people can dance.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. And it happened.
It happened.
Exactly.
It's a process.
Yeah.
So, guys, it will be a hit song.
Very mad.
You need to do a very nice video, man. You sacrifice even your money, you sacrifice to take a very nice video. So, what can you advise me?
I want you to start going to Melbourne studios. Just here in Qatar, you know the location. you just ask that this guy will help you in what's it called? Some more of the singing, he'll help you. He's a music teacher, so he'll help you out in more of the singing.
Singing part?
Yeah, it will improve gradually, you know. Yeah. So
on the side of melody, I know how to create melodies, I know how to compose. Writing music is not my problem.
So what he'll do, he'll improve that.
Because he's a music teacher.
Yeah, he'll improve that. You will see the difference in self once you and don't ever stop doing music. Don't let music kill you.
For example, I'm doing content here. I've not never stopped doing content. Exactly. Despite, I'm not earning anything from these things, but I'm still doing it. You see? So if I could be a lazy person, I could have stopped doing it. But you see, I did not stop doing it.
Yeah, never stop. Mm. Never stop the reggae.
Mm. I cannot. So, what can you tell an upcoming guy outside there?
Never stop doing you, man. Never stop. Never stop the reggae. Mm. Never stop doing music. If you're an upcoming artist, my name is Devon David. Make everybody freaky. I'm located in Utawala, in Kenya, if you're in Kenya, that's it.
Yeah.
And I do music recording and vocal teaching.
So if one want to find you in Kenya, you can find you in Utawala?
Yeah, Utawala.
Mm.
Yeah.
Because I can say one thing about vocal teaching. Yeah. You also have taught me a lot about vocal training.
Exactly.
So I cannot say, you taught me about how to change the what do you call it?
Rhythm.
Yeah. Because you're not the only one like this.
Exactly.
And but I don't know if people will be able to listen to my first songs because most of them are not released them. But if they could have listened to them, they could have seen the gradual growth.
Yeah.
But only us, we have the songs. So maybe we will release them one day.
Yeah, of course. But you know, I'm waiting for you also. Mm. You're the one to decide when it's going to be released.
Yeah. You know, I do not want just to release our songs without completing. I wanted first to complete the project first. To reach the target first. Yeah. Then when I started releasing, I have a video out.
You have something to
show. Something that will market me first.
Yeah.
That's what we do. You first make the project as a business, in a business world. You make the product, then you start marketing the product. Yeah, people in the market now.
Exactly.
So that's the reason I've never answered you. Why you ask me, why are you not releasing? So
man.
I wanted first to make the music first.
I wanted people to hear what you're doing, what you're putting on the table.
I wanted first to make, to create first. That's why I wanted to create first. After creating, then I release. But something has made us stop along the way of creating now. It's just some shit happened. It's life.
It's called life.
Don't ask what shit. It's life. So maybe, as a man, you go through ups and downs, but we never give up. So you're telling us where you are located. Where can people find you?
Yeah, in Utawala. If you're in Kenya, Nairobi, you get me at Utawala.
And you tell people your contacts,
my
email?
Contact, just look for me in Instagram or WhatsApp or anywhere as Never on the Beat.
Okay.
Yeah, just look for me in Instagram. Never on the Beat. You can get my contact there. You can look for me. Yeah, man.
So what can you tell an upcoming musician who is out there in the street? You know, some people want to be musician, but they don't have money to pay studio. Can you support one of them?
What I tell artists, you use money to get money. You get, even myself, before I got this recording equipment and everything, I had to travel. I had to find a way to look for that money so that I can buy this equipment to record. So it applies the same. I've never recorded a song. You know that? I've never recorded a song before. I had to look for money and pay for that studio time so that I can record a song. So if you really love this music, just
you sacrifice your money and deep in your heart.
Yeah, man. Because you just have to sacrifice.
So after sacrificing, also people will, after you release even one song, people will get to know you and feel you.
Exactly.
So even if someone wants to support you, will support
they
you.
Will support you.
But if you have nothing to put on the table, who will support you?
Man, we came to this earth as one person. No one came like until you came, two people in this. You came as one. And there's no one who will ever support your dreams except yourself. That's what I tell myself. If I have a dream, I must make it happen myself. I must go and do the necessary hustling and everything to support my dream. You get me? Yeah, because your dream, you're only seeing it yourself. No one else is seeing that dream. You get me? Yeah, man.
So guys, thank you, man, for your time to appear in this video. And I hope we'll make another video in Nairobi.
Yeah, of course. You must do that thing.
No, it's pain me, my day. It's the last time I did video with my sister when he was going to Mayolo.
Yeah.
Then also I'm doing another video with you. It's so much emotion, man. All my friends are leaving me here. And I'm feeling very bad, man. If you see that video, I don't like putting those type of... It's last video in Qatar, man. It was very emotional. Now we are doing a day video. All the time I'll be doing with you night videos.
Exactly.
Now we're doing a daylight video. So guys, you understand why we're doing a daylight videos. It's one of the last videos we're doing here in Qatar.
Inside K, inside your dano. Never on the beach, make everybody freaky. Yeah.
One word for your lady fans.
Yeah?
Your lady fans.
I love you so much. Beautiful women, beautiful African ladies, beautiful Asian ladies, beautiful European ladies. I love yours, man. I do this music for you.
And before we wrap up, what have you learned in the Qatar music scene? Because you have been into so many shows here, what have you learned? You have worked with many artists here. Which of the artists you have worked here, you feel this artist has a potential?
Digzy254.
Oh, Digzy, my friend.
Yeah, man.
We met in a very funny way.
Yeah.
At your studio, and we were long time buddies.
Man. And there's KG Supreme, he's a Ghanaian. And there's this other artist. The name is.
Riot. The big artist, you say that this artist has potential to conquer.
Yeah, man, there's this artist.
Digzy, you know, he's an OG.
Yeah, that's an OG, man. And Gaza One. This artist, they are big artists, let me say that.
In Qatar.
They are big artists.
Yeah, Qatar, from Africa.
The music scene, here in Qatar, as underground artists, they've set the trend. Now, for like, people like me and Riot, they're trying to set
the pace.
Exactly.
And in Kenya, which ones did you work with? You say this guy has potential, just that the yes, no, Aja Penya. Only one.
Doesnt. Yeah.
It's an artist you see has potential to conquer.
Yeah, that's my father in music.
Best producer, the ones you will see, this my producer will be a king in the next future.
Sage.
Big up, Sage. I know one day maybe we can meet. Then one thing he told me, that if I make it, I will run away and look, I will go to record labels. Why do you tell me that thing? I will run to record labels, that's why I come here. Why do you say that?
I don't know. Once the music start hitting the limelight, people take it.
So you think I can run away from you and the way you brought me from down here until then I run away because of music labels?
I can't tell.
No. If you have to go to music labels, there must be a process. Understand?
Yeah, man. But once the money hits,
you don't forget where you came from. Don't forget where you came from. Or someone. Let's, for example, we're doing this video with you here.
Yeah, man.
You're going to be, it's just check. We're doing this video with you here. Then, for example, this video in your Kuomoka, this video makes it up. Or one of my place where I'm up like this. I'm supposed also to look for you, also to uplift you. That's what we call brotherhood.
Yeah,
understand?
Man.
Even if I do a song, it hits. Even if I'm going to that label, I know you can also, I can come call you, come, we do this song, and it hits also you.
Sure.
Hits.
Yeah, man, that's what it's called, brother.
Brother, you don't just say, well, I ran away, I forgot about you. No, that's not a good thing. Even if you go and shine up, look for the person who are you.
Of course.
That's why I sang that song, Auju
ya
Kesho. That song?
Yeah.
Oh, you forget that song?
I
now
recall
remember.
It.
Auju ya Kesho.
Yeah.
So you don't know what will happen tomorrow. So much of the music you should listen to, there's something, a message I'm passing them. If they are happiness. We have those songs I do, someone just sits down and listen to the message. Even if the beat is nice, but also the message sticks in that person's mind. That's the type of music I do.
That's very nice.
Or maybe if a song starts making good royalties and I forget about you. Leave those other agreements. Someone can run away from those agreements. But there's one thing I'm calling brotherhood.
Yeah.
So, someone I from down, you cannot leave him like that. You see, I'm putting it on camera.
Yeah, man, I get you.
And also, maybe you will go there. Maybe you hear my songs like this, or me here like this. Then I tried contacting you. You're disturbing me. No. If you're somewhere, you are stuck, just tell me like this. If I have something, we can talk. Yeah,
man.
And also, you said we're going to do an album.
Yeah, we must do an album.
I will work on the lyrics. You know, I want to work with the lyrics so that the lyrics are ready, the recording is no problem.
Yeah.
Lyrics are the biggest problem. Because I don't know, I want to write shit.
Exactly.
If it's a party song, you have to have some party songs, you have to have some nice songs, or love songs, also have some
Viking
songs, yeah. So guys, thank you guys for being with us. Anything you can tell us before we end? Now your time now to shine.
Time to shine. Follow Nevo on the beat on all social media platforms and EVO on the beats. Wagwan. Yeah, and I love you all, man. We'll see each other in other platforms. Wagwan ji. Wagwan for that.
So guys, thank you. See you one and last time. See you guys. Thank you very much.
Kaysa, you done.